The snap parliamentary elections are being held in Ukraine today. They were announced after the sixth president of Ukraine, Volodymyr Zelensky, took office. On May the 20th, during his inauguration speech in parliament, he announced that he was dissolving the eighth convocation of the Verkhovna Rada of Ukraine. The very next day, after consulting with the leaders of the parliamentary factions, the president signed a decree on the dissolution of the Verkhovna Rada and set the day for the snap election, July the 21st, 2019. According to the president, the legal basis for this was the absence of the parliamentary coalition since 2016, as well as the low level of citizens' trust in the institution. The survey done by the Razumkov Center in February showed that the level of Ukrainians' confidence in the parliament did not exceed 12%. Their colleagues from the Kyiv International Institute of Sociology conducted their own survey in December. Their result was 8%. According to the Constitution, snap parliamentary elections are held within 60 days from the date of the publication of the decision on early dissolution of the parliament. The current legislation on elections of Ukraine states that the parliament is elected using a mixed electoral system. Half of the candidates are chosen from the closed party lists, the other half from the constituencies. The entry barrier is 5% of the votes. The parliament consists of 450 MPs. However, back in 2014, after Russia annexed Crimea and began the aggression in eastern Ukraine, part of the single-member districts were occupied. These are 10 districts in Crimea and 2 in Sevastopol, 9 districts in the Donetsk region, 6 districts in the Luhansk region. In 2019, 424 deputies will be elected to the Verkhovna Rada. The number of registered candidates is hundreds of times more, 5,984. There are 22 parties running for parliament in the nationwide multi-member constituencies. They have 2,746 people in their lists. As for 199 single-member districts, 3,220 candidates are running there. 1,447 people were nominated by political parties, 1,773 persons are self-nominees. On average, the competition is 13 people per seat. The numbers on the list were determined by drawing lots. Ballot papers for single-member constituencies differ depending on the number of candidates. Up to 6 candidates, 20 by 20 centimeters, up to 11 candidates, 20 by 30 centimeters, up to 18 candidates, 20 by 40 centimeters, up to 33 candidates, 20 by 60 centimeters, up to 50 candidates, 20 by 80 centimeters, and the longest up to 60 candidates, 20 by 90 centimeters. The shortest list in a constituency in the city of Khmelnytsky features 5 candidates. The longest one consists of 46 names. In single-member districts, the candidate who receives the most votes wins. If two candidates get the same amount of votes, the second round of voting is held. It should take place no later than 2 weeks after the Central Election Commission decides that the second round is necessary. The Central Election Commission needs to announce the official results of the election no later than on the 15th day after the voting by August the 5th. By August the 10th, the results should be published in the official press. According to the Constitution, the Parliament should hold its first session no later than on the 30th day after the results of the election are officially announced, which is by September the 9th, 2019. However, according to the President's party, it's planned to hold the session in August. It may take place on August the 24th and be dedicated to Ukraine's Independence Day.